Hello friends, the next topic of our discussion is the common emitter configuration of BJT. In common emitter configuration, the base side is input, the emitter terminal is common and collector side is output. So we take output from the collector. Resistance is connected on the collector circuit, that is load is connected in the collector circuit. Input is given from the base and emitter is common terminal. I'll be taking NPN transistor where arrow is put on emitter, that is outward. This is NPN transistor. Fine. So here again, just like you have seen in previous video, that was common base configuration. Here we'll be defining again the input characteristic, the output characteristics and some few more points which are related to the common emitter configuration. Remember one thing, configuration is the most commonly used configuration in analog electronics. Maybe for switching applications in digital and pulse circuits and maybe in amplifier applications, the common emitter configuration with NPN transistor is the most commonly used configuration. Fine. So now let us talk about the input characteristic. The input characteristic of your common emitter configuration gives you, that is basically the VBE voltage, that is input voltage, is function of the base current and the voltage VCE. Voltage VCE is the voltage terminals, total voltage. Fine. So here again I will be deviating from the convention of mathematics. As per mathematics, this should be y axis, this should be x axis, but I'll be taking the base current as the x axis as per the convention of PN junction characteristic. X axis I'll be fine. This is the input junction. So I'll be taking variation in IB with function as a function of VBE. I am connecting it in forward active mode with positive at base, emitter common, similarly positive at collector and negative on this side. So we will see whether it is operating in which region, either active, saturation, cutoff, while discussing the characteristic. Fine. So initially when VBE is applied, current remains zero for some moment and then it starts increasing like this. Just like your common base configuration. And when you apply the voltage VC, when you increase the voltage VCE, it will shift like this. Please do remember this. Here it is VCE1, it is VCE2, and it is for VCE3. This is for VCE3. Fine. I'll say this is for VCE2, VCE1. So for the same base to emitter voltage, base current is decreasing. You can see I have the three different values for same base to emitter voltage. What could be the reason? Reason we have already discussed. I'll talk about the reason again. VCE3 is greater than VCE2 is greater than VCE1. Fine. For constant voltage VB, and this is nothing but again that same cut-in voltage. I'll not say that same cut-in, but this is dash. We will see why it is dash here. Fine. When I increase this voltage, we're keeping this voltage as constant, so VCB voltage will be increasing. When I increase this, keeping this constant, this voltage will increase. So the voltage at collector junction will increase. And this is positive, this is negative, this is positive, this will be negative. So reverse biasing voltage at collector junction will increase with increase in voltage VCE if the voltage VB is held constant. How? Please see, VCE, voltage VCE is what? Voltage VCB, VCB plus VBE. If I keep this as constant and increase this, the only possibility is VCB should increase. If the voltage at collector junction increases, we have seen in common base configuration, if voltage at VCB is increased, the collector junction voltage is increasing, reverse biasing collector junction voltage is increasing. And when reverse biasing voltage at collector junction increases, width of the depletion layer at collector junction will increase. If width of the collector junction increases, the effective width of the base will decrease. Please do try to recall what we discussed in case of common base configuration. This is your collector junction, this is your emitter junction, this is base terminal, this is emitter terminal, and this is collector terminal. When I increase reverse biasing voltage VCB, this voltage is VCB, this voltage is VBE. So keeping VBE constant, if I increase this voltage, so initially say this is the depletion layer at collector junction. So if I increase, the width of the depletion layer will increase, and effective width of the base, which was earlier this much, now it will be this. This is WB, this is WB dash. Effective width of the base will reduce. When effective width of the base reduces, what is happened? Less number of carriers will be recombining, because there will be less time for electrons to stay in the base region. Why? Because I'm taking NPN transistor. So electrons which were injected from emitter will be traveling for lesser time in the base and will be reaching at the collector junction quickly. Why? Because your effective width of the base has reduced. So that means less recombination will be taking place in the base region, and base of the charge carriers in the base region. So if less recombination is happening in the base region, so that means base current will reduce. So if I increase VCB, base current will reduce with increase in VCB, and VCB means I am saying VC here. If I am increasing VC, so VCB is increasing. So with increase in VCE, your base current will reduce because of the base width modulation, which is also known as early effect. Please do remember this. The base current reduces with increasing the voltage VCE because of the early effect. This is the point to be remembered. Otherwise, input characteristics are similar, because that PN junction is forward bias in common emitter configuration, just like your simple PN junction. The only thing is there is one controlling parameter, which is VCE, the base current with increasing VC. Fine. This is your input characteristic. So please remember the shape and nature of the characteristic. There can be question on it, especially in engineering services prelims examination. Now let us talk about the next characteristic, that is output characteristic of common base configuration. The output characteristic of common base configuration, output is what? Output current is collector current, which is function of input is what? That is your base current, and voltage on output side is what? VCE. So this is your output characteristic. Fine. So let us draw the output characteristic here. The output characteristic will be like this. Again, now I will be following the convention of mathematics. This is y-axis, so this is y-axis, this is x-axis. I will be taking VCE on x-axis, voltage VCE. Fine. Now, again, just whatever we discussed earlier, I will be just talking about those points now. When, if you talk about IC as a function of IB, so this is beta into IB plus 1 plus beta into, I'm just writing the expression of your collector current. The collector current IC is what? IC is beta into IB plus 1 plus beta into IC naught. Fine. When I reduce this current IB to 0, when I reduce this IB to 0, this is IB, current is like this. So when IB is 0, when IB is 0, what will be IC? IC will be equal to, that current is known as ICE naught, that is 1 plus beta into IC naught. Please see, when I reduce this current to 0, IB to 0, when I reduce the current IB to 0, this is open. When this is open, there is current in from collector to emitter. That current is known as ICE, current between collector and emitter. ICE naught, naught means your base is open. Fine. So that current is ICE naught, that is 1 plus beta into IC naught. Please do remember this. So when IB is 0, please see this current is how much? That current is ICE naught. Fine. Now another point, when I increase B further, so let us see what will happen. Your characteristic will be like this, like this, like this. That is how it is going to happen. It is not similar to what you discussed in case of the common base configuration. This is IB1, this is IB2, which is definitely more than IB1. This is IB3, which is definitely more than IB2. This is IB4, which is definitely more than IB3. Fine. But there is interesting observation here. What is that observation? The output characteristic in case of common base were almost flat, like this, like this. But here it is having slope. That means collector current is not constant with respect to VC, rather it is increasing. So in case of common base configuration, your collector current is almost independent of voltage VCB, but x-axis was VCB in common base configuration. In case of common base configuration, IC is almost independent of VCB. That was function of emitter current only. But here it is increasing. Reason of increasing, we have just seen, when voltage VC increases, the emitter current increases because of the base width modulation, and hence the collector current increases. So collector current increases, collector current is increasing with increasing VC, and VC, we have just seen VC means indirectly, that is VCB. Why? Because VCE, I have shown, VCE is VCB plus VB. If VBE is held constant, so VCB will be giving me VCB. Fine. So what I mean to say is, this has slope. So we will see it later, one by one. Here, please see this region where it is having slope, this region. This region is known as saturation region. Fine. This voltage is known as VCE sat, VCE saturation. Fine. This region, please see it carefully. IB equal to 0. This is not cut off in case of common emitter configuration. Why it is not cut off? When I reduce IB to 0, what will happen? That will give me ICE naught. What should be the cutoff? Cutoff means output current should be 0. That is the meaning of cutoff. IC should become 0. But here IC is not becoming 0 when I'm making this 0. If I'm opening this, that is not becoming 0. Rather, that is ICE naught. So ICE naught is quite a large quantity as compared to IC naught. Why? Because beta is of range of 99. So it is 100 times IC naught. So if IC naught is in the range of microamperes, it will reach in milliamperes. So I cannot neglect ICE naught for cutoff region. So instead of making it, having IB equal to 0, I must reduce the emitter current to 0. I should reduce this current to 0 for cutoff. If it is 0, so this will become 0, almost 0. So here, for cutoff region, this should be equal to IC naught, and this can be equal to IC naught only if when IE is 0. Please remember this. For cutoff region, IE is 0, not IB in output characteristic of BJT in common emitter configuration. IB equal to 0 will not be the sufficient condition for cutoff. So for reducing IE to 0, what should I do? I apply a small reverse bias voltage here. Just by reverse biasing the input junction, I will be able to reduce IE to 0 approximately, because when your input junction is also reverse bias, so current will become negligible through that junction. So for reducing, for making the collector current to almost to saturation, reverse saturation current, that is IC naught, I must reduce IE to approximately equal to 0. When IE is 0, so what will happen? There will be current in this junction, that is IC naught, so current will be negligible in the circuit. That's what I'm trying to say. So this will be, if this is 0, so what will be IB? Approximately equal to IC naught. So I will say IB will be equal to, here IB will be equal to IC naught, not 0. IB will be equal to IC naught for cutoff region. Why I am repeating? For this to be 0, or for cutoff region, IC should be negligible. If I open this, IC will be equal to current through the reverse bias collector junction, so that is IC naught. So cutoff condition for common emitter configuration is IE equal to 0, not IB equal to 0. So IB will be equal to IC naught for cutoff. So this is cutoff region. Please do remember this. In case of common base configuration, I was setting IE equal to 0 here for cutoff. But for common emitter, since this is controlling, IB is IB naught, it is not 0 for cutoff region. Number 2, please see this. When I am increasing VCE, current, collector current is also increasing slightly, and I told you the region. When I increase VCB, reverse biasing voltage, or other way around, when I increase VCE, if VB is held constant, so VCB will be increasing. If VCB is increasing, the voltage, the reverse biasing voltage at collector junction is increasing. When reverse biasing voltage at collector junction is increasing, base width will reduce and depletion layer width will increase. And what is happening? Initially, suppose, please see this, this is your base region. Initially, suppose this was the edge of the depletion layer, so majority carriers will be reducing in the base region and reaches at 0 at the edge of the depletion layer on collector layer. But if you increase VCB, the depletion layer width will shift this way, it will shift this way, and this gradient will change. Why? Because at the edge, it should, the concentration of electrons which is injected in base region should become 0 at this point, at the edge of the depletion layer. So gradient of the injected minority carriers in the base region will increase, and I am repeating, emitter current is approximately equal to collector current, and that is area of emitter junction Q dN dN by dx. Gradient is increasing, so collector current will also increase. Please do remember it, this is important. So when I increase VCE, so VCB is increasing, effective width, the width of depletion layer at collector junction will increase, effective width decrease in effective width of the base region will result into increase in gradient of concentration. Increase in gradient of concentration will result in increase in collector current and emitter current. This effect is known as early effect or base width modulation. So collector current will slightly increase with increase in VCE because of the early effect. Please remember this. Fine. And when you come to this region, so for this region is what? This region is active region. this region is cutoff region, and region to the left, when your collector current is becoming almost constant, the region to the left side of that is called saturation region. In the saturation region, voltage on output side is VCE. In the saturation region, voltage on output side is very small. It is of order of what? 0.1 volt, approximately 0.2 for silicon and 0.1 volt for germanium. So this voltage on the output side is very small. So if it is very small and current collector current is large, so if your load current means collector current is load current, if your load current is large, voltage drop across the device is small. So that is the condition of what? A closed switch. So BJT behaves like a closed switch in the saturation region. Let us talk about active region. In active region, your collector current is linear function of input current, that is beta. So it behaves like a linear amplifier in which region? In output, in your active region. But remember, it is not always linear. Linear will be only if the same change in your base current results in same change in collector current. Although it is not exact linear, there is some non-linearity in the output characteristic in your active region. Fine, but we will assume that your collector current is linear function of IB. So your output current increases linearly with the input current, that is base current. So that is why we call it as the linear current amplifier in active region. In base region, in cutoff region, let us see, your output current is IC naught. So that is negligible, whatever is the voltage. So it behaves like an open switch. So BJT behaves like an open switch in cutoff region, it behaves like a closed switch in saturation region, it behaves like a current amplifier in active region. So when you use this as an amplifier, so you have to operate in cutoff region. Now let us see one concept here. Let us see the important concept, that is concept of load line. That concept is important. Let us see what is the load line. If you see the output side, please see the output side. What is IC from output side? VCC minus this voltage divided by RL. So VCC minus VCE divided by RL is the collector current. Or I can modify this IC equal to minus 1 by RL into VCE plus VCC by RL. If you see, if I make it this as y-axis, this mx plus c, what is y? Y is y-axis IC. What is x? VCE. What is m? Minus 1 by RL. What is c? That is VCC by RL. And you know the equation of straight line? Y-axis, slope of the line. This is equation of a straight line. Y-axis, slope of the line, that is this, minus 1 by RL. X-axis and C is intercept with the y-axis. Equation of a straight line. It means this is equation of a straight line. If you draw this line on this plane, IC is y-axis, VC is x-axis. So if you draw the line, that line will be something like this. Please see it carefully. That line will be this. So if you see this line, see it carefully. This point is what? VCC upon RL. This point is what? If you see on the x-axis, this point, this is VCC. And remember, this equation, this line is called load line. This equation represents which line? Load line. So this is known as load line. Why? Because this line is being determined by the load RL. That is why we call this as the load line. So I am trying to overlap two things now. These are the characteristics of BJT as a device. This is the line which is determined by the external circuit. If you overlap this, remember, if there is intersection between the output characteristic of BJT and this load line, this point of intersection between the output characteristic of BJT and the load line is called Q point. That is known as Q point. We sometimes call this as the operating point. Q point is sometimes called the operating point. Now, so this line is fixed. This line is fixed. If you change, what can we change? If you change VCC, if you change VCC, accordingly this point will shift. But if I change this equation will not change. So if I change IB, the point of intersection will change. When IB becomes equal to IB naught, this Q point will shift here. Please understand, I'm not changing VCC, I'm not changing VCE, I'm not changing RL, I'm not changing output side. I am changing base current. How can I change? By changing RB and VBB. But what is IB? Please see this. IB here is VBB minus VBE by RB. This voltage minus this voltage divided by this. So I can change IB by either by controlling RB or by controlling VBB. VB is a constant voltage or maybe very small voltage. So by changing the base current, if base current is this much, Q point will be this. If base current is this much, Q point will be this. If base current is this much, Q point is this. So operating point will shift along the load line. When base current is equal to IC naught, how can it become IC naught? I open the emitter terminal. That becomes IC naught. If not, your BJT operation enters into the cutoff region. If base current is maybe IC3, your operating point will enter into this region. And this current corresponding to this value is called ICESAT. So beyond this, I'm saying if that depends upon the load line. If for this particular load line, IB3 will be sufficient enough to drive the BJT into saturation. ICESAT. So what is ICESAT? Please see it carefully. ICESAT is, if you see, that is equal to, see this voltage? At for ICESAT, what is the voltage? VCESAT? So VCC, it means I'm saying, if you see this relation, see this equation here, ICESAT, see it carefully. The collector current at saturation, at boundary of saturation, will be VCC minus VCESAT. VCESAT means the saturation voltage. And saturation voltage is of order of 0.1 volt for germanium and 0.2 volt for silicon. That's fixed. Fine. So this will be the current given for the saturation limit. If your base current becomes more than this, BJT enters into saturation boundary. Your boundary of active and saturation region. What is that boundary? The IC, your IB is equal to ICESAT by beta. That is boundary. If base current becomes more than this, so your BJT enters into saturation. If your BJT will be entering into saturation when, if IB becomes this critical value, that is ICESAT by beta. Please remember this. This is very important. This is very important. There are questions on this, especially in engineering services, and there can be one more question in GATE as well. BJT enters into saturation if the input current becomes more than this. because my operating point will always move along the load line. If I'm changing base current, say from here, IB naught, it is shifting, and when current reaches here, that limit is reached. And how do I find IC sat? That is nothing but, what is IC sat? I have given you the expression. IC sat is nothing but VCC minus VCE sat and by RL. And this is fixed for our device. VCE saturation is fixed. So the moment voltage reaches at VCE saturation, your saturation current, collector current is fixed. So if you go on increasing base current, your device will enter into saturation beyond this point. So if I increase IB more than IC sat by beta, if IB is more than this critical value, that is called deep saturation. That is called as deep saturation, hard saturation. If IB is more than this critical value, BJT is called in hard saturation or deep saturation. In case of hard saturation or deep saturation, your voltage will become VC will become less than VC set. Fine. So that is how we have the output characteristic. There are certain points. In case of saturation region, your collector current is almost independent of VC. It is not varying with VC. Fine. But in active region, your collector current increases slightly with VC because of which effect? Early effect. So there are, these are some of the points you should remember. So in as far as your common emitter configuration is concerned, this is very important topic. But let us talk about the biasing conditions. In saturation region, this was the region, your base junction, your base emitter junction and collector emitter junction both are forward biased for saturation region. Please do remember, I have discussed in case of modes of operation, when base emitter and base collector junction are forward biased, BJT is in saturation region. When base emitter junction is forward biased, collector junction is reverse biased, it is in active region. When your base emitter junction is reverse bias, collector junction is reverse bias, it is in cutoff region. This is very important question in exam. There are plenty of questions in GATE and engineering services only on this concept, the region of operation, whether it is in saturation or in cutoff or in active region, because that will decide the behavior of the device. In pulse and digital circuits, device is operated as a switch. So it is operated in cutoff and saturation regions. But when it is used for amplifier applications, it is used for as an amplifier. It is operated in active region. So your operating point should be from here to here when it is being used as an amplifier. Your operating point should be here when it is used as an open switch. Your operating point should be here when it is used as a closed switch. So for when you are turning it on and off, so I have to switch between this and this and changing from here to here. It has, the operating point has to traverse along this load line. If through the active region, that takes time. That requires time, and that time is known as rise and fall time. Fine. We will see it later on in switching characteristics of BJT. But for the time being, just remember these characteristics. These are important. Now, there is important point here. When your device is in cutoff region, when your device is in cutoff, the current which is not or ICB not. So in cutoff region, your IC is equal to IC not, and that is nothing but ICB not. That is reverse saturation current. And you should remember, reverse saturation current, if you remember the PN junction diode, the reverse saturation current doubles for every 10 degree rise in temperature for both silicon and germanium. So I'll say ICB not 2 is equal to ICB not 1 into 2 raised to power T2 minus T1 by 10. So what I mean to say is, ICB naught doubles for every 10 degree rise in temperature for both silicon and germanium. Whatever is the type of material, the reverse saturation current doubles for every 10 degree rise in temperature. This is important point here. Second point, I have the forward biasing voltage across the junction, and we know the forward biasing voltage across a p-n junction is a function of temperature. So I am considering effect of temperature here. I am considering effect, topic here is effect of temperature on what? On ICB naught and voltage VBC, VBE and VCB. That's what I am trying to say. So voltage VBE is function of temperature, and that varies at the rate of 2.5 millivolt per degree rise in temperature for both silicon and germanium. Please do remember this. The voltage VBE decreases with increasing temperature because of electron hole pairs generation in the depletion layer. So base emitter junction or junction voltage, you can say forward biasing junction voltage reduces with increasing temperature at the rate of this. Similarly, voltage VCB under forward biasing condition, or VBC rather, you can say voltage VBC will also change at the same rate, millivolt per degree rise in temperature. These are important topics for numericals in GATE as well as in engineering services. There are plenty of questions on what I am discussing. And please remember one thing, I do lot of research before I teach you these topics. I do analysis of engineering services, I do analysis of GATE, I solve each and every question, I do analysis of civil services mains, I do analysis of engineering services electrical, engineering services electronics, then GATE electrical, GATE instrumentation, GATE electronics. I see all the questions first, solve each and every question, then design the material to be taught, then I teach. So it's not just like that I come and start teaching just like any conventional faculty. So I do lot of research before I take. My most of time is gone in preparation and solution of the question. This video is hardly taking 30 minutes, but I devote 5 to 6 hours a day for the preparation of what I'm teaching, for deciding what I have to teach. So please do take each and every point very seriously, otherwise what will happen? When you go and appear in the exam, you will come and see these videos again to see your answers. So rather than doing that, try to see the videos very seriously, try to solve each and every question so that you don't need to come and see these videos again. That's one important point to be noted for you. So please take every bit of what I'm giving, and it is the experience which is speaking, it's not me. So now I'll be talking about the next topic in the same subtopic rather, in common emitter configuration. That is, let us see how the collector current varies with the voltage VBE. It is sort of transfer characteristic. That is, variation in IC with respect to voltage VBE. When you have voltage VBE on x-axis, the current IC on this axis, so the variation is like this. Like this. This current, collector current and base to emitter voltage. So input is voltage, output is current. So sometimes we call it sort of the transfer characteristic. So when this is dividing this into three parts. This is VCB 0. When VBE 0, when VBE 0 here, this is cut off. Fine. Then I have a cut in voltage. The collector current does not, you know, collector current is what? Collector current is function of what? Alpha IE plus IC naught. And we have seen emitter current changes what? Emitter current changes with, or I'll say beta into IB. Beta into IB plus 1 plus beta into IC naught. You can say like that also. So current IB and VB, you know that increases like this after certain point. So collector current will become measurable only after certain point value of IB, or similarly you can take IE as well here. And if you remember IE, this was cut in voltage. Fine, but in that case IC has to be written like this, alpha IE plus IC naught. That's how you have. Fine. So initially when VBE is 0, I'll say it is cut off or negative, VBE is 0 or negative. But at after certain point, I have a cut in voltage where your collector current starts increasing after cut in voltage. Fine. So that is increasing, and after when you go on increasing, your this VBE will be large. And that is nothing but VBE sat, saturation voltage. Fine. So from here to here, it is called active region. Why? Because your base emitter junction should be forward biased for active region. So this is active region after cutting. And from here to here, it is saturation region, which is after VBE sat. Fine. So this sort of characteristic is known as your transfer characteristics. We can define like that. But when VB is 0 to this, there is no current. That current is very small, and that is known as cut-in region. Right? It is cut-in, means there is no collector current, or current, collector current is very small. And this current, this side, when VB is negative, is nothing but IC naught. When VB means your emitter junction is reverse bias, when emitter junction is reverse bias, it is basically when it is reverse bias, the current through the junction is collector current is IC naught. But when at this point, when it is the stage of cut-in, so there somewhere here, very close to this, this current is ICE naught. It means when you open the base, there will be some voltage, VBE voltage. I'm opening the base. When base is open, still there is some voltage across the, there is current through the collector, that is ICE naught. So that is how we have the variation characteristic. I have taken this characteristic from the Milman-Helkias. But you don't have question has never appeared on whatever I am discussing, just for your understanding that what different, there is a variation in IC with respect to B, and we have the different regions like this. Fine. So then if you can remember, there are voltages, different voltages given for value of VB for different regions. So there can be question on that as well, especially in engineering services. Let us see that. I'll be giving you that in tabular form. I'll be taking three rows. Here I'll be taking silicon BJT, then germanium BJT. I'll be taking VBE, then three different values of VBE I'll be taking. VBE cutoff, first is VBE cutoff, then VBE cutting, that is V gamma we have taken, VBE cutting, then I'll be taking VBE active. Then I'll be taking VBE saturation. and then I'll be taking one more voltage, that is VCE saturation. This is important, especially from numerical point of view as well. Normally it is given, but if you can remember, you should remember it. This VBE cutoff is 0, minus 0.1 volt for cutoff region of operation. Then I have VBE active, VBE cut in, I'm sorry. This is 0.5 volt for this silicon. This is 0.1 volt for here. VBE active is slightly more than this. It is 0.8 volt here. And 0.3 volt, I think it is in germanium. This is 0.2 volt here, 0.1 volt here. It is in between, somewhere like this. Fine. These are the voltages for different regions of operation in for your BJT in common emitter configuration. And please do remember, if you can remember these voltages, it will help you in objective type questions. Maybe there can be one mark question directly in engineering services, and it will help you in solving the numericals, conventional and objective type questions. So do remember, if you can remember it. I have discussed the operating point as well. So there are some points here in common emitter configuration, that is amplification factors. Amplification factor or gain. First we will call as DC gain. Fine, DC gain. DC gain, here it is defined by first beta DC, and that is ratio of IC upon IB. Please do remember this. Beta DC is this. Then large signal gain. That large signal gain is derived from this equation. IC is equal to beta IB plus 1 plus beta IC naught. Or this gives, that is IC, I have to find beta here. So beta will be equal to, that is nothing but IC minus IC naught divided by IB plus IC naught. This is called large signal gain. Fine. Then small signal gain. Small signal gain, beta is defined as the change in collector current per unit change in base current for constant voltage of VCE, for fixed value of VCE. That is called small signal gain. Fine. Normally, in normal case, if nothing is mentioned, we take beta DC is equal to beta is equal to beta AC. This is small signal gain. That is what we take in normal case. Fine, if nothing is mentioned. So this is all about your common emitter configuration. There are some points I will be comparing, but just for your knowledge. Input current, I'll be comparing your input resistance, output resistance, voltage gain, current gain. I'll be comparing these six to seven parameters. Once I discuss the common collector configuration as well, there I'll be discussing all the three, and that is important from examination point of view. But this is how much you have to cover for common emitter configuration. Topic is very important as far as exam is concerned. So please do remember all the points whatever we have discussed, and wait for my next video. Thank you for watching.